is a very exciting vlog, if I do say so myself. So we are actually getting some new jumps today. They are being delivered. They are jumps for joy jumps, which is very, very exciting. I've been waiting a couple of weeks now for them to be made, and yeah, so they're coming today and I'll be able to show you what they look like. We only got, I think, about 4 jumps because they're quite expensive, but of course they are worth it and I'm so excited to start using them. And yeah, so I'll wait for them to arrive and show you all that, and then I'll get some videos of me jumping the new jumps and you'll be able to see the horse's first reactions, which may be interesting. Quick little side note, so I thought it'd be quite interesting for me to show you guys the process of me choosing which jumps I wanted and how easy it is to use their website. As on their website, they have like a jump configurator kind of thing where you can build your own course, which I thought was really, really good. And you can see exactly how the jumps are going to turn out and exactly what they look like and whether the poles match or the fillers match and stuff like that. As I feel like it's really good to be able to see the end product without obviously them arriving, then maybe you might not like the colours as much. So yeah, it's a really good thing that they have on their website. And I thought it would be quite good for me to show you guys the process of us picking the jumps and the different colours and what the jumps actually look like on the website compared to what they look like in real life. So yeah, enjoy. So this is the Jump for Joy website. As you can see, I will go on to where the course maker is. So yeah, the jump builder and design studio is where you can make your own jumps. And this is just me going through what the process was to make one of the jumps, and then afterwards I will just be doing it in time lapse mode just so you can see what I'm doing but also not be sitting here for hours. So yeah, enjoy. This is me showing you how I made the Jump for Joy / Union Jack plank jump. So yeah. So yeah, the jumps arrived and me and Mum helped get them out of the truck or lorry, and as you can see there's quite a lot. We did help him, but obviously we didn't touch him or anything, and yeah, we just started unpacking them. I didn't actually film us putting them all up, only because it honestly took us quite a while as me and my mum were quite stupid and we didn't know how to do it, but we did get into a rhythm and managed to get it done quite quickly. But me being my usual crappy vlogger self, I completely forgot to put my phone on time lapse, and yeah, so this is the only bit you'll get to see of us putting them together, but to be honest it wasn't even that interesting anyway. So next we did start unpacking them. I did get a bit excited and I put them all up just so I could get a good video of them up. So here it is. This is what they look like. Honestly, I was so happy what they look like. They look amazing. They are literally the best jumps, and I'm so happy with how they turn out. Like, they are literally perfect and look exactly like they did on the website. And yeah, I couldn't have asked for much better, to be honest. I mean, they did get two of the poles wrong, but to be honest, they were amazing about it, and they literally got the correct poles to us within like 2 days, and they were the poles on the plank jump. But yeah, so here they are after we'd moved them over to the arena. As you can see, my dad built some pole racks, which was really helpful, as I really don't like leaving them on the floor. So yeah, it just makes it look a lot neater as well. So I'm just going to show you how they will set out. All the older poles were on the right with the Solway show jump poles, and then all the newer poles were on the left. And these are all the wings, fillers, water trays, all of that type of stuff. Today I'm just going to give both the boys a jump. Brian is just going to have a quick little jump as he's still coming back into jumping work, and then Ryan is actually having a lesson afterwards. So I'm just going to set out like a little course or a little exercise to do with Brian, and then whatever Ruby chooses to do with me and Ryan, we will do. So let's take you over there to have a look at the jumps. So here is a little exercise I set up, thank you to someone on Instagram. So it is just 3 strides from the double down to the red and yellow upright on a dog leg, or you can do it the other way to the jump dry oxar, or you can also go from the skinny 3 strides down to the yellow, red and yellow, which was really good. So yeah, I was just really happy with how the jumps turned out, and they honestly looked amazing, and I was so beyond excited to use them. So the Brian videos I chose to take away the audio, because all you could hear was the dogs barking because they are so annoying, and I just thought it is literally gonna go straight through you all. So I just took out the audio for that. So yeah, this is Brian jumping, and then next will be Ryan's lesson where you can hear what Ruby says.
Ever off, Brian. Ryan.
So that is it for today's video. I just want to say a huge thank you to everyone that watched, and hopefully you enjoyed it. I know it wasn't very long, but there wasn't really much more I could add, and I haven't really been jumping them. Well, that was the first time I actually jumped them over the new jumps in that video, as it's been really warm and I'm not really a hot weather person. I'm hoping that I can start vlogging more now. I've just been really lazy and unmotivated because, like I said, I'm not really a hot weather person and I don't like being out there in this weather. I like to just get up in the morning, get my jobs done at like 7 and then go inside and sleep. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, and let me know down below if there's anything you'd like to see in the next videos. Make sure to like, comment and subscribe if you liked it, and yeah, thank you for watching.